Hello everyone and welcome to NewGelds 101. Today I will introduce you to a new component in our TMS FNC UI pack, the TMS FNC Hotspot Image. For some of you, it might already sound a bit familiar, as there is a version of this component in our VCL and FMX products. But now we will bring this to the FNC library, which means that it is available for VCL, FMX, TMS WebCore and Lazarus with the same code base. For those of you that don't know what a Hotspot Image does, it is a component where you can define different areas or hotspots, as we call them, on an image, and you can define them with an individual name and appearance. There is a blog post on how the demo that is added to the packages works, and I will leave a link for that in the description. But now in this video, I will show you how we use the hover bitmap. And I will do this with the help of the famous painting Children's Games, painted by the Flemish Renaissance painter Breugel the Elder, which is a painting of over 80 different games played by children. For this, I used two different images. The polarized one and a grayscale one that I've created. And I want to show the games that I already placed a hotspot on, to show colorized and to show the name and some additional information. Like for this part, I have mock tournaments, which are competitions of various kinds. I have the making a balloon and the handstand, which is here actually a headstand, but okay. But this is what I want to show. So you can also put links in there, then if you click on them, you can go to there, but I've made them not selectable. You can see this here in the editor, which is available in design time, but also in runtime as a component where you can reshape and define your hotspots as you want. So as you can see, here is the hover bitmap set. If you clear this, it will use the fill color as it is set or as you want. So this is the default fill color, which will be used when you create new ones. But here we can change it as well. Make it gradient, give it a texture or none. But let's add the hover bitmap again. Now it gets back to this one. So this will pick the part of the shape of the hotspot out of the hover bitmap and show it here. So I've made them non-selectable. I want to show them, because if you don't show them, then you can't see them, because you can use those in three different states: the hover state when you go over them, the down state when the mouse is down, and the selected one. So I've chosen not to show them on down and selected, but only when it's hovered. But we can say that we want to have them shown on selected as well. Then make them green or something like that. Then we have to make them selectable. We can add the different new hotspots with the new and delete or here. This does the same. And I'll give you a quick overview of the tools. So you can make a square, which is done here for the lady blowing up a pig's bladder. Then the ellipse tool, let's say for example, we'll do this one here, add a new one. And this is throwing hats, change name, but then it's changed. Then the magic wand tool, because of the bad conversion I did, I've lost a lot of data, but I'll show you here in the top. With the wand sensitivity, you can select how much of the color that you want. And with the wand density, you can choose how many points are used. Then next to that, you have the add. So this is used for the handstand and the mocking parts, where you just click on different points and create your polygon as you want. Another thing that you can do is, of course, the select one. I've forgotten that one, where you can just select the polygon that you want and even fine tune by moving specific points or removing and adding them. Again, with this point you can just add where you want or remove. Then the eraser is just to clear the complete polygon that you've created, and then, as I already mentioned, the new hotspot and the remove hotspot, so you can just remove that one. So we want to show the hotspot and also show the name. This needs to be set on. As you can see now, this was added. The hotspot name needs to be set in the hotspot image on the hotspot name location where I set the top center, so it's shown here. What did I do to show the extra information? So this is the data string that I've shown you, which is the additional information that you can add to a hotspot, and I'll show this here in the label. And this is done on the event when the hover hotspot changed. So I quickly check if the hotspot, the hover index is greater than -1, which is none is hovered. If it does, I'll retrieve the data string and show it in the caption. You can use this to open a URL or show anything else as you want. This was a quick example of how the hover bitmap works in the TMS FNC hotspot image. You can do the same for the selected bitmap, and then it shows the part of the image when one of the hotspots is in a selected state. Next to that, there are a lot of other possibilities with the fills, the gradients, the textures, and so on. And those you can see in our blog post, for which again I will leave a link in the description. So have a look at that, have a look at our demo code and our doc, and hopefully you'll find your way in the TMS FNC hotspot image and it can become an advantage to you in your programs. Thank you for watching. Till the next time.